A couple of months ago, I did a very detailed walkthrough as to how I'm using the note-taking app Obsidian. If you haven't seen it, I'll put a link to it in the description below along with everything else I mentioned in this video. In that video, I mentioned I was going to follow up on a few things that I just didn't have time to go into in detail. That video was incredibly long as it is. And I've also been doing a couple of new things with Obsidian as well. This video is sponsored by Saily. Let's get into it. The Obsidian team just released a new app called the Obsidian Webclipper. This is a Safari extension. This is a web extension that works with Obsidian to save websites and articles as notes. It works incredibly well. When on a site you want to save, just select the clipper from the extension menu. This will then save that whole page as text to a new clippings folder. When saving the page, it adds a ton of metadata, including the author name, publication and save date, source title, and even a description of the page. It will also take that web page and turn it into a full markdown file. This includes headers and proper markdown links. If you don't want to save the whole page from a website, you can highlight just the bit you want to save. This can be a sentence or two, or even a few paragraphs. Then if you run the extension, it will save just that information. When adding something through the clipper, you can edit any of the property information, including the title if you want something that stands out a bit more or is easier to search for. If you're using a keyboard with your iPad or the Mac, you can use the shortcut Option-Shift-O to bring up the clipper. When in the clipper window, there is a settings panel where you can adjust a ton of features, including keyboard shortcuts. You can also set up templates for clippings and enable an AI interpreter if you wish. Personally, I haven't felt the need to use these options yet, but it's really cool that they're there if you want them. Now, because of this new web clipper, I've moved all of my bookmarking out of the app raindrop.io. I used to use that for saving links to apps, stuff I wanted to cover on the channel, you name it, it was a link, it got saved there. With the Obsidian web clipper, I can have it pull all the metadata I want. It pulls all the links, everything I need, plus it's in my note-taking app, so I can then use backlinks to link things together. Obsidian is now 100% where all of my research and writing goes. Like I said before, I still kept some links and organized a few things in raindrop.io, but I'm really happy with this web clipper and what it gives me. Another thing I mentioned in the last Obsidian video that I would go into a little bit more detail with is my daily note and how I'm using that. Now, Daily Note is a built-in core plugin. If you go into Settings, Core Plugin, Daily Note, you should see it right there. Turn it on if it's off. Now, I use Daily Notes as kind of a scratch pad, a place to kind of journal about what's going on in the day, things I'm thinking about, stuff I want to work on, things like that, and log what I did in that day beyond a task manager. This really helps with my ADHD just to kind of like write down like, hey, you accomplished these 5 things today. Works really well for me. And every day I write about something I'm excited for. I recently added the excited section. I really want to just focus on more positive things, whether it's work or my personal life. Now, instead of recreating the bones of this document every day, I use a template. In Obsidian, there is another core plugin called templates. It creates a folder in your Obsidian vault, and in here you can build out template documents that you can autofill in new documents if you wish. For my daily note template, I use a special name so that it's always titled that day's date. Just type open curly bracket, date, close curly bracket, no spaces. For the rest of the document, just build it out however you like. I just use markdown headers to design it all. Nothing special. Because I use this template, it makes it really easy for me to add or remove sections in the future. Once you have your template built, go into Settings, Core Template, and Daily Note. Here you can add the path to your Daily Note template. So whatever your template folder name is, for me it's just templates, then /, and then the document name, which for me again is open curly bracket, date, close curly bracket. Now I did take this a step further and added a keyboard shortcut so I can just quickly jump to that day's daily note. Go into Settings, Hotkey, and then find Open Today's Daily Note. I assigned the keyboard shortcut Command-Shift-D. So no matter where I am in Obsidian, I can hit this and it'll jump to exactly that day's daily note. Really handy. This video is sponsored by Saily. Saily is an eSIM service provider. They offer easy and seamless connectivity so you can set up your mobile device without the need for a physical SIM. Now, Saily is perfect for traveling. They support over 160 countries and 8 regions. What this means is you don't have to worry about roaming or any extra international charges from your carrier while you're traveling. With Saily, if you're traveling abroad, you'll never get lost because you'll always be connected to the internet. My girlfriend and I, we just took a trip for our anniversary, and on this trip, my main cellular provider had terrible coverage. I was actually able to use Saily as a data backup. And because of this, and it just worked out to be perfect timing, I was able to use Saily to get directions to places, call Ubers, look up places to eat, and even send messages. Saily is incredibly easy to set up. You just go and download the app, pick a plan, and then install your eSIM. Super simple. Get an exclusive 15% off your Saily data plan. Use the code Lolly at checkout. Be sure to download the Saily app or go to saily.com/lolly. I mentioned in that first Obsidian video, I would go a lot deeper in a document I call Launchpad. This is a document that links to everything I'm currently working on, important notes, and documents from my Quick Note folder, essentially a home base in Obsidian. Now, you could easily build something like this by manually backlinking to all the documents you want, but it's not very efficient. Instead, I use a third-party plugin called Dataview. This allows you to query folders and tags and build lists and tables out of that. Dataview is hands down one of the most popular plugins for Obsidian because it is incredibly powerful what you can do with it. Now, I'm just going to be touching on a fraction of what Dataview can do. There's so much it can do. I'll put links to all the documentation about it so you can read up on it and figure out all the kinds of different things it can do, but I'm going to talk about how I'm using it right now. So my Launchpad document is split into different sections and uses a combination of lists and tables for Dataview. The first section is my important notes. For the Launchpad document, I start off by creating a markdown heading with its name. I also add an emoji so I can just quickly see the section if I'm scrolling through. And frankly, it makes the document a little bit more vibrant. When starting with Dataview, you have to type 3 backticks and then Dataview. After that, you can define what kind of view it is, either a list or a table. For this view, I'm using a table. If you're using a table, you can establish what parameters from the note is shown in the table. I'll put a link in the description below to a list of all the different parameters you can use. There's quite a few. For this one, I'm using file.folder. This pulls the name of the folder in which the document is from. By typing out file.folder, capital as, then quote, and folder, it renames that section of the table to folder. The other property I am using is file.cday. This shows the created date for that note. I also do the same thing for the naming of this property, as quote date created end quote. This way it's labeled as date created. Then the last bit of information is where the note you want is pulled from. Because my important notes are stored all over in different folders in my vault, I use tags. So you type a capital from, ampersand or hashtag important. This pulls every note that has the tag important. You can easily tag any note by just typing anywhere in it, hashtag, and then the tag name, no spaces. Now, to close off Dataview, you have to add 3 more backticks on the very last line. This is how you set up a table in Dataview. To edit a pre-established Dataview list or table, put the insertion point anywhere in that document. Then use the arrow keys to either scroll up or down into Dataview, and then just pause for a second. It'll show the code for that table. The Quick Notes section uses the list view. These are just notes that are in my Quick Note folder. Typically, these are created with my Capture Cut shortcut and added here. This is stuff I want to get out of my head and just make a note of quickly. Now, for this view, instead of typing table, we type list in all capital letters. Then the from is in quotes and the name of the folder exactly. For me, I use underscore quick note. The underscore is because I want this folder always to be at the top of my list. Close it off with 3 backticks and there you have it. This will pull every note from the quick note folder. The last 3 sections in my Launchpad document are all very similar. These use the table view, but pull from different properties. I have here research, video projects, and comfort zone, which are all folders. For research and video projects, I use the parameters file.outlink. This will display every backlink to another note in that document. Again, I rename this parameter using the asQuoteName technique. Research is for projects I'm working on or will soon be working on. I love being able to quickly just jump into this and make notes about something I might discover. The video projects folders are all my scripts, and in those scripts, I have links to the sponsors for that video. I have a document for every sponsor with scripts and information, and putting this in the table means I can just quickly glance at what video belongs where. The last section is comfort zone, and this pulls all my notes for each episode. This again uses the table view. Then the property file.cday as date. This will show the date created. Then at the bottom, I use sort file.cday DESC. This puts the newest document up top. I just started this a couple of weeks ago, so some of the older ones are a bit out of sync. The only issue I've had with Dataview so far is I've been trying to filter out some of the older comfort zone notes, like, you know, ones from weeks ago I don't need anymore. But there is a filter property, but for some reason it's just not working right now. But that right there is my Launchpad document. At no point am I manually adding backlinks to any document. These are all being pulled using Dataview. So that means if I move a file out of like my video projects, like I move a script out of there, it automatically gets removed from Launchpad. Or if something gets added to a research or quick note folder, it automatically gets put in here. Same if like I tag something important, automatically added. I'm never manually adding backlinks to this document, which means it's constantly staying up to date. If I had to manually edit this document all the time, it wouldn't get done. So that's what I've been doing with Obsidian. If you have any questions or if there's something specific you want to see in a future video about Obsidian, because I'm definitely going to make more Obsidian videos, let me know in the comments below. My thanks to Saily for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.